The Garbage Patrol, Chicago style, at 10.
Be it ever so humble.
Who cares? Not me. If we're just your normal family. And the vacuum cleaner's busted. And the children aren't adjusted. I got you, you got me. And we can wrestle this economy. So let our station wagon rattle through the suburbs of Seattle. I'll tell the world that we are happy in our domesticity.
Bacon, there's something leaner.
Tasty sizzling.
Whoa, sis, what's the matter with my bacon?
Here's what's the matter. F-A-T, fat. Sizzling's 50% leaner than bacon. It's all real meat without all the fat.
And why sizzle fat when you can sizzling?
Mmm, delicious.
Move over, bacon. There's something leaner.
So why sizzle fat? Sizzling.
Now get instant savings on sizzling beef strips.
You probably can't guess where you can find all this under one roof. Probably not at the stereo store at the mall. Probably not at the TV shop. Or the computer center across town. You'll find all this at Sears. That's right, Sears.
There's more for your life at Sears.
Okay, Mom, don't worry. The products are going to sell themselves. Just give me the presentation the way you're going to give it to the bridge club.
All right. Oh, it's just that I get so nervous when I have to speak in front of people.
Okay, just imagine that I'm Mrs. Mawbury, and it's my first day back after my chin job.
I am here today to introduce you to the miracle that is Nathway. From detergent to mascara, to radiator flush. Products for your car or products for your face. Made with love from Earth to you. Take, for instance, our most popular product, Does All. Now, can you do this with your household cleaner? Not convinced yet? Okay, then can you do this with your household cleaner? I'm convinced. Still not convinced. All right, then can you do this with your household cleaner?
Calm down.
Does All is made with completely biodegradable and organic ingredients. So it's safe around children and pets. And it tastes just like punch. Not great punch. But it leaves your teeth white and scuff-proof.
Great, huh? Now I know how to clean those hard-to-reach spots. Like my intestines.
You know, Harold, it really kills me that I have to miss these games and not see my son in action, but... Well, I just started this job, and I can't really ask for time off yet.
That's okay, Dad.
No, it's not okay, Harold. I remember how important it was that my dad was there whenever I played. He was there the most important game of my life. We were a run behind. One man on, so I knew I had to go for the long ball. And the pitcher was... Stumpy Marcus. Curveball pitcher. And, you know, I could never hit a curveball. So I just dug in, and I swung from the heels. And I hit that one. I hit that one good. A real long shot out to deep left center with the center fielder. He was off with the crack of the bat right out there. And it's back to the fence, back to the fence, back to the fence. Going, going, going. Say bye-bye, baby. And I remember as I was circling those base paths, the way the crowd all got to their feet as one. My dad rushed out on that field and gave me a great big hug. What a hit. What a day. What a game. What a sport. What a country. So, you nervous about playing the Braves?
I wasn't. Nah, just kidding. Piece of cake.
Piece of cake. Will you listen to this guy? I mean, it's the final crucial game of the year. It's going to decide the playoffs. This guy's steady as a rock. What a guy. Good luck, Slugger.
In 2 minutes, everybody.
Jeff, do I have time for, like, a quick phone call?
Sorry, Mr. Gray.
Nervous, Martin?
Yeah, I'm dying to find out who won my son's baseball game.
I know something you don't know.
What is it, Cliff?
Guess.
I don't want to guess.
Oh, come on, guess, Martin.
I don't want to guess.
Guess, Martin.
All right, they're making a sequel to E.T.
They are?
Cliff, whatever it is, you know, just keep it to yourself. I'm not interested.
Bet you'd be interested if I told you it had to do with a certain baseball game that just finished up yesterday.
What? What do you know about that game, Cliff? Who won?
Guess.
Mark, for heaven's sake. The Sox won. That's my boy.
1 minute, everybody.
It's gonna be some playoff, eh, Martin?
Oh, I think with a chip off the old crane out there, there's gonna be no contest.
You know, Martin, life is funny. Isn't it funny, Martin?
No, not at the moment, no. Yes, it is. I mean, here we are. We're co-workers, neighbors, friends. Now my Amy and your Harold are going to be pitted against one another in a field of competition.
Amy's playing?
Playing? She's pitching.
Boy, she may be a dainty little cutie, but she's got an arm like Bob Feller. Now, that's nothing a little electrolysis can't fix, Clint.
I understand your son plays right field,
better known as the Twilight Zone.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Coming up at 5, more Washington drug and sex scandals.
And Amy Hamilton, first Seattle girl to take her baseball team to city playoffs. But in my segment, what goes through the mind of a young Harold Crane on the eve of baseball history? Stay with us.
Hi, honey, I'm home. Hi, Dee Dee.
Hi.
Where's Harold? His old man wants to pour root beer over his head.
He's not home yet.
Oh, well, he's probably still with his friends, his teammates, his compadres, reliving those great moments of the game.
Hi. Ta-da!
There's our little slugger. Hip, hip.
Hooray!
Hip, hip.
Hooray!
Hip, hip. Hooray! Way to go, slugger.
Congratulations, Harold. Tonight's your night. What would you like to do to celebrate? We can go out to eat. We can go to 97 Flavors. We can go to the arcade. Anything you want. Name it.
Thanks. But if you don't mind, I'll just go up to my room and sit in the dark.
Come in?
I guess.
What's troubling you, son? Your mother and I'd like to help if we can.
You can't help me. Nobody can help me. I hate my life. But don't let it worry you.
Sweetheart, this should be a happy time for you. Can't you tell us what has you so worried?
Okay. I'm scared about being in the playoffs.
Oh, Honey, is that it? Come here. Well, honey, we all get scared. Why, today at my Natway meeting, I was terrified. 15 people all staring up at me. I almost couldn't get down the cleaner. But I did. You'll do fine.
Okay. Here's the real truth. I've been lying to you. I'm not quite the ball player I led you to think I am.
What do you mean, son?
I mean I stink. I didn't want to tell you sooner because I know how much it means to you for me to be good. But I'm not. I can't hit, I can't feel, I can't run. I was voted most tidy.
You know, Harold, I think you're being a little bit too modest about yourself. I'll bet you've made some very valuable contributions to that team.
Very valuable. I take them all out for burgers and fries so they don't beat me up. Mom? Dad? I know this sounds like the coward's way out, but I'm going to save us all a lot of torture and humiliation and call in sick tomorrow.
Now, wait a minute, Harold. Don't you think it might be better to face this thing head on? It doesn't matter to us if you win or lose.
I can't do it. Don't make me.
Sweetheart, if that's the way you feel about it, then you don't have to play.
Hold on, Candy. Just hold on.
Martin,
Candy?
He doesn't...
Harold has got to learn that sometimes he can't just take the easy road out. And I think he'll respect himself a lot more if he faces up to this thing.
Martin, he's only 10.
Well, okay, do this for me, then. Sleep on it. Think about it. And if tomorrow you still feel the same way, well, we're not going to stop you.
Thanks, Dad. You just made my 10 teammates very happy.
Oh, here. Still hope you play.
Morning.
Good morning, Harold. Well, how do you feel?
Not too well, Dad. Woke up with a stiff neck.
Oh. Okay, that's the way it's going to be then. Okay.
But I'm playing anyway.
That's my boy.
Maybelline asks, what do you want to say about yourself today? You're a superstar. Say it in blooming colors. You're just one of the girls. Say it in blooming colors. You're complex and serious. Say it in blooming colors. But you never want to grow up. Say it in blooming colors, shadows. Colors that say who you are, how you're feeling, what you're all about. Whether you want to express your style or express your love. Say it in blooming colors by Maybelline.
The only sugar-free for my kids, pre-sweetened with a natural-tasting sweetener.
Outstanding.
At about half the price of soda with vitamin C, it's the one I like best. The one they like best.
The one sugar-free.
Sugar-free for kids.
Kool-Aid brand sugar-free soft drink mix.
Next, two college buddies and the woman they both love are caught up in the politics and passions of the 60s. Little did they know their ideal world was about to crumble.
Either you play it safe or you take a chance. Now, I believe in taking a chance.
Brad Davis, Karen Allen, and Simon & Simon's Jameson Parker star in A Small Circle of Friends. Next.
In a CBS special presentation, a courageous band of rabbits fighting for their lives escape on a perilous journey to Watership Down. Saturday at 8, 7, Central and Mountain.
Gentlemen, welcome to the 10th annual Pop Gruber League playoffs. Let's take a moment now to remember Pop Gruber, who devoted his entire life to just two things, his delicatessen and baseball.
All right, listen up, you men. Listen up now. What do you say? Listen up. Every one of you men played your hearts out to get where we are today. And I want you to know that no matter what happens out there, all of you men have every right to be very proud of yourselves for having gotten this far. Now, what do you say? Hey, yeah. All right. However, if we don't win this game today, it'll be a crime against the Lord. And you will carry the shame of it with you for the rest of your lives. Da-da-da-da-da-da!
Charge?
Excuse me, fella.
Yeah.
This dugout's reserved for team personnel only.
Oh, that's okay, because I'm his father. Yeah.
Jerry's father! Oh, listen. Jerry, I want to tell you, that kid gets 110% out there.
I'm
all
sure
the
he
time.
Does. I'm
what
sure
a
does.
Kid, I really...
Harold's father.
Oh.
How's the neck, Harold?
Swell.
Oh, I can see that.
Now, where the heck is that Mr. Blue? Gosh darn that son of a gun! Now, there are supposed to be two adults in this dugout at all times. One to keep score. Cecil, right and pop throughs while we... You. Harold's dad?
Yeah, Crane. Martin Crane.
Crane. Oh, that's a wonderful scorekeeper's name. How'd you like to keep score for us?
Oh, golly gee. Wizards, Coach. Do you mean to actually spend the whole game here in the dugout?
I said I need an adult.
Right. You're right to say that. Of course I can help you out here.
Thank you, Mr. Crane. All right, men. We're going to go out there now. Harris, first base. Johnson, second base. Henderson, third base. Speaker, short. Schwartz, left field. Valdez, center field. Paulson, right field. Platt, catcher. And Miller is the team. All right, men. What do you say out there? Let's climb out there. Honey, beep. Hey, let's
chatter out here. Coach, I hate to be one of those pushy fathers.
Don't be.
But, what about Crane?
He'll be perfectly safe where he is.
Yay! Harold! Yay!
No, Harold's not out there.
He isn't.
Oh. Well, I wonder where he is. Well, maybe they're saving him for when they're in trouble.
Oh, yeah, that's right, Judy. When they put Harold in there, they're in trouble. Oh. Hey, that's my Amy. That's my little slugger. Doesn't she look great?
Yeah, real butch.
Johnson digs in at the bottom of the third, stops leading a squeaker, 12-11.
Well, you know, Coach, I never realized what a grueling, nerve-wracking job it is to coach a little kid's baseball team.
Well, when you love kids, it's really no trouble at all. I just treat them all as if they were my own. Johnson! That pitcher's in the dirt! How can you swing at a pitch like that, you blind nutskull?
Do you, have any kids of your own?
They live with their mother. Harold Crane, you're in.
Who, me?
Yes, you. I have to put you in now. I'm not going to blow this game on a technicality just because I didn't put all my boys in.
I'll let those words inspire me.
Now batting for the Sox and looking very neat, Harold Crane.
Yay, Harold! Knock one out of the park! For you, Ma.
All right.
in the parking lot.
Oh, no. Don't let it come here.
No, actual baseballs are supposed to come to right field. Now I'm going to have to lie and say,
I got it! I got it! I got it! I got it! Look at it! Look at it!
This is so humiliating.
Do you have enough money to put your kid through college? Without an athletic scholarship.
Yikes! Two pop flies to right field in one game? What are the odds of that? This time I'm not going to look like an even bigger idiot by yelling,
I got it! I got it! I got it!
No! Better! It's going to cost the Sox another run, making it 26-23, Spartan. Okay. Sox are down to their last three outs.
Well, son, you gave it your all, but this game is just too important to us. I'm going to have to take you out and put Stevens in.
Hey, where'd he go, Coach?
Hey, oh, hold on there, Coach. I realize I'm just a father here, but come on. You can't expect all these guys to play like Sandy Koufax.
Well, I can at least expect them to play like Sandy Duncan. Look, we're 2 for 3. It's best for all concerned.
Please return all foul balls to the announcer's booth.
How do you feel, son?
Well, not too bad. Actually, I've had much worse days than this. Ask anyone here.
Yeah.
You know, I think I owe you an apology. When I pressured you into playing, I'm not so sure if I was more concerned about your welfare or mine. I know you didn't want to play, and maybe you were right after all. I just should have listened to you more.
Well, I'm still glad I played. But I just wish I could have done something to make you proud of me.
You just did?
Yeah?
Yeah.
Great.
What a game, fans. Final inning, two outs, bases loaded. The score is tied 26-26.
All right, Stevens. It's all on your shoulders now, boy. Anybody seen Stevens?
Coach, is Stevens kind of a big, muscle-bound kid with, like, a single eyebrow, a lot of hair on his arms?
That's it.
Yeah, he said he had to go make potty.
The lame brain cotton pickets. Trey? Harold Trey, you're up now. Get in there, boy.
Me?
Yes, you, Harold.
Far be it for me to second guess you, but you took me out of the game.
But I didn't. You're our last stop and our last hope, boy. Get in there now.
Harold.
I got faith in you, boy. Stevens went potty, and now we're in the potty with him.
I can leave town quietly. Maybe get a job on the Alaska pipeline. We're not through with it yet. And the pay is good.
Hamilton kicks and fires. Strike one. Oh, breaking ball over the inside corner.
I wonder if the Merchant Marines take children.
Little Amy comes back.
Strike two.
Strike two. Yeah. Crane knows that the Red Sox are down in their last strike.
He's a hero. Thank you, my son. You got hit by the pitch.
away. We'll be right back.
Closed for inventory.
Will it take all day?
Always does. That's why I just put the Energizer in that calculator.
Of all leading battery brands, nothing outlasts the Energizer from Eveready. Nothing outsnaps it, outplays, outshines, outlasts it. Nothing.
Done. This is still energized. Now I can use it to figure out my overtime.
The Energizer. Energize for life.
Long life. Exclusive supplier of flashlights and batteries to the 1984 Olympic Games.
For Bonnie Castevens, airline reservations agent, headaches come with the job.
I have a headache. I need some aspirin, please.
Today we'd like you to try extra strength Tylenol. It works without aspirin.
I have to try it. I feel wonderful. The headache's gone. I could handle my job. I can handle whatever they want to throw my way.
Extra strength Tylenol. You can't buy a more potent pain reliever without a prescription. Now Tylenol introduces caplets, specially coated and shaped so they're easy to swallow. New extra strength Tylenol caplets.
I'll be up in a second, honey.
Batting third, number 24, Marty Crane.
Go get him, Marty. Go get him, son.
Don't be Rhymes. Here's the 3-2 pitch.
Honey, remember to turn off the light.
Yeah, I got it.
Stay tuned as Brad Davis, Karen Allen, and Simon & Simon's Jameson Parker star in A Small Circle of Friends on the CBS Tuesday Night Movies next, following news break.
Good evening. From CBS News, this is Newsbreak. The Democratic campaign began today as Walter Mondale joined running mate Geraldine Ferraro in her Queens, New York district. He told the crowd he smelled victory in the air. After a stop in Cleveland, the two candidates went to Jackson, Mississippi. In an interview with an Atlanta television station released tonight, President Reagan said, too many debates with his rival would, as he put it, bore the pants off the viewers. But Mr. Reagan said perhaps two debates would be agreeable. Now this.
A taste so smooth, it could only be Michelob. Some things speak for themselves.
Idaho Republican Congressman George Hansen was reprimanded by the House today for filing false financial disclosure forms. Earlier, Hansen received a prison sentence for violating the Ethics in Government Act. He's free pending appeal. I'm Marlene Sanders, CBS News, New York. More news later on this CBS station and on Nightwatch.
This is CBS.
Tonight on the Channel 2 News, the Cubs are not the only story around Wrigley Field. There's this city garbage crew that's picking up trash at a nearby business. The story is, that's illegal. Walter Jacobson explains tonight.